Asian honeybees are currently established in Far North Queensland and are expected to slowly spread throughout their natural range in Australia. The techniques demonstrated in this short video are to guide pest control operators in the destruction and management of Asian honeybee swarms and nests. Asian honeybees do not appear to be any more aggressive than European honeybees and are described as having a gentle temperament. Asian honeybees are smaller and less hairy than European honeybees. They also have more prominent and even banding on their abdomen. This pest has been known to nest in and around urban environments, so they're more likely to come into contact with humans. Before destroying any bees, ensure they are Asian honeybees and not European honeybees or a native species of bee. Asian honeybee swarms are most often noticed when they are stationary and clinging together in a dense cluster. They can be found hanging from almost any object and usually vary from the size of a closed adult hand up to the size of a basketball. The swarm of bees is looking for a suitable home and will typically move on after a short period of time, though they can stay for a couple of days. Personal protective equipment should always be used when attempting to destroy bees. We recommend two people are present to ensure each other's safety, keep onlookers at bay, and in case of an emergency. If someone is stung and they are showing signs of an allergic reaction, they may need urgent medical assistance. Using a flying insect spray aerosol and a plastic bag is the most effective technique to contain and kill a swarm that is easy to reach and accessible. Do not use a product that states that it should not be used around bees. First, assess the swarm and how it is attached. Remove any objects in the way of the swarm, or in this case, any plant stems that may get in the way while you're placing the bag around the mass of bees. Ensure you have selected a suitable sized bag to hold all of the bees. In one slow, smooth motion, enclose the mass of bees and bring your hands together at the top to seal them in. Gently shake the swarm mass until it breaks its attachment to the branch and drops into the bag. Tying the bag and placing it inside another bag will ensure none escape. Spray the area where the swarm was originally hanging to discourage any uncaptured bees from reforming. A few escaped bees will be flying around. You can either spray these with the aerosol, or you can slowly move away from the area. Pierce a small hole or make a small opening in the bag containing the bees and spray with insecticide. When a swarm is too high or unreachable, or the previous method cannot be utilised, an aerosol liquid spray can be used. These can be used on an angle of 15 degrees and will reach up to 4 metres. It can also be attached to a specially made extension pole applicator to reach extremely high places. Do not use this product over or near waterways and always wear safety glasses. Asian honeybee nests can be found in a wide variety of cavities and environments. There will be consistent movement of bees in and out of the entrance during daylight hours, and you may see evidence of bees carrying pollen back to the nest. There should be a loud and active humming sound coming from inside the cavity. Look for any evidence of exit holes that the bees will use to try and escape. Sometimes these exit holes can lead to the inside of a building or house. Where possible, plug these up using damp paper towels or anything that will fit before applying any chemicals. When ready to start killing the bees, begin spraying the main entry point of the nest with a well-shaken can of flying insect spray. Keep the direction of the spray moving around the whole nest cavity and, if possible, attempt to penetrate the structure of the cone.
It's going good. Okay, hear the hum? Still going? Okay, keep giving it more.
Where a fast knockdown is needed, or you need a product that is safe to use around high and low voltage equipment, a specially formulated high output liquid insect spray can be used, such as a liquid jet wasp killer. Situations may include bee nests within fuse and meter boxes and around live electrical wires. Permethrin dust is a common synthetic chemical widely used as an insecticide, including the destruction of feral honeybees. Due to its fine and lightweight properties, it's highly effective when penetrating inaccessible spaces, such as house walls. As seen here, the dust can be dispensed into a cavity using a bulb applicator, or there are electric blower applicators on the market for large nests and cavities. The fine residual dust penetrates the cavity, covering the comb and surrounding surfaces of the nest. Bees will crawl through the fine powder and take the poison back to the nest. As with all of these methods, the entrance to the nest should be plugged after chemicals have been used. You should now be hearing a considerably lower humming sound coming from the cavity. Once this dies down completely, you can assume the bees are dead. It is important to clean the area of any dead bees, as dead bees can still sting and cause a severe reaction. If possible, clean away comb and honey to ensure other bees do not take up residence or rodents and other scavengers are not attracted to the leftover food source. Two of these methods are captured in a printable step-by-step guide available on Biosecurity Queensland's website. This guide has additional information, including checklists for responding to a public call, a full list of recommended equipment, and what to look for and what to do if stung. For more information on Asian honeybees, visit www.biosecurity.qld.gov.au or call 13 25 23 and always report suspect bees, especially around port areas.